بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
Muhammad bin Al-Jazari, the great Quran and Hadith scholar of the 9th century, says in his famous poem, detailing the rules of tajweed, and applying tajweed is an issue of absolute necessity. Whoever doesn't apply tajweed to the Quran, then a sinner is he. So he regarded it as an obligation and he regarded leaving it as a sin. And the majority of scholars agree that applying the tajweed rules of Quran or an individual obligation upon every Muslim who has memorized or read part of or all of the Quran. This is because the Quran was revealed with the tajweed rules applied to it. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam recited it back to Jibreel in that way. And the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam read it in that way. So it's an established sunnah.
وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ رَسُولٍ إِلَّا بِلِسَانِ قَوْمِهِ لِيُبَيِّنَ لَهُمْ.
And we did not send any messenger except in the language of his people to state clearly for them. At the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there was no need for people to study tajweed because they talk with what is now known as tajweed. So it was natural for them. When the Arabs started mixing with the non-Arabs as Islam spread, mistakes in Quran recitation started appearing. So the scholars had to record the rules. Now because the everyday Arabic that Arabs speak has changed so much from the classical Arabic with which the Quran was revealed, even Arabs have to study tajweed. The linguistic meaning of tajweed is to beautify something. The technical meaning of tajweed is to give every letter its right with its description and its origination. Tajweed is one of the most honored of sciences and one of the best of them due to its relation to Allah's words. The tajweed rule setter from the practical point of view is the messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because the Quran was revealed to him from Allah the Most High with tajweed, and he sallallahu alaihi wasallam was instructed on it from the trustworthy Jibreel, peace be upon him. He taught it to his companions, who then taught it to their followers, and so on until it came to us by these chains. Tajweed rule setters from the scientific point of view or the scholars of Quranic sciences, such as Abu Ubaid al-Qasim bin Sulam. The knowledge of tajweed is contingent on four matters: knowledge of the articulation points of the letters, knowledge of the characteristics of the letters, knowledge of what rules change in the letters due to the order of letters, exercising the tongue, and a lot of repetition. Ibn al-Jazari, may Allah have mercy on him, says in his poem about acquiring tajweed, and there is no obstacle between it and leaving it, except that a person must exercise his mouth with it. The scholars have divided the types of mistakes one might fall into when reciting the Quran into two types: clear mistakes and unobvious mistakes. The clear mistakes must be avoided by all, and to avoid them, one must know the rules of tajweed. If a person falls into the clear mistakes, this is considered a sin, and Ibn Taymiyyah, may Allah have mercy on him, even regarded it undesirable for a student of knowledge to pray behind a person who makes clear mistakes in their salah. As for the unobvious mistakes, then the ruling on them is lighter, and the recitation of a person falling into this type of mistake is regarded as lacking in completeness, and prayer behind such a person is sound. And recite the Quran in a style. Ali bin Abi Talib radiallahu anhu said in the explanation of this ayah, At-tartil is tajweed of the letters and knowing where to stop. And of the rights of reciting correctly is reciting it in the way it was revealed. There are various ahadith also showing us the importance of tajweed. Umm Salamah radiallahu anha was asked about the recitation of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and she described it as a recitation, clearly distinguished letter by letter. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to recite the Quran in slow, measured, rhythmic tones, as Allah had instructed him. Not hurriedly, but rather he would recite a surah in such slow rhythmic tones that it would be longer than it would seem possible. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would stop at the end of each ayah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam commanded people to recite in a beautiful voice, in a pleasant, melodious tone. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Beautify the Quran with your voices." And he sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "He who does not recite the Quran in a pleasant tone is not of us." And once when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam complimented Abu Musa al-Ash'ari radiallahu anhu on the beauty of his recitation, Abu Musa radiallahu anhu said, "Had I known you were there, I would have made my voice more pleasant and emotional for you." Aisha radiallahu anha relates that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Verily, the one who recites the Quran beautifully, smoothly, and precisely, he will be in the company of the noble and obedient angels. And as for the one who recites with difficulty, stammering or stumbling through its verses, then he will have twice that reward." Uthman radiallahu anhu said that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "The best of you are the ones who learn the Quran and teach it to others." The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Whoever reads a letter from the Book of Allah, he will have a reward, and that reward will be multiplied by 10. I am not saying that Alif Lam Mim is a letter. Rather, I am saying that Alif is a letter, Lam is a letter, and Mim is a letter. The Quran is an intercessor, something given permission to intercede, and it's rightfully believed in. Whoever puts it in front of him, it'll lead him to paradise. Whoever puts it behind him, it'll steer him to the hellfire.